Hello guys, and today I'll be showing you insecure deserialization practical. So let's get started. So this is the website where we want to do this. So firstly, let's start by understanding a little bit about cookies. So over here, when I'll go and I'll log in, oh no, you need to create an account first. So join us, username, let's keep it as subs. Password as 1234 and let's sign up. Alright, so now how to check cookies is I'll just going to inspect element storage, and over here I can check the cookies. So I'll go and I'll take this session ID cookie and I'll copy this and I'll just go and I paste it here. So why am I pasting it here, I'll explain you. So firstly, I can see the double to equal to, which means that this could be encoded with base 64. I use base 64 and I get the answer. This is encoded and this is the flag. Alright, so don't worry, I am just telling you. So second procedure, what they have asked us to do is to get admin access via this cookie stuff. So I'll just go here, inspect element storage, and over here in the cookie, rather than the session being as a user, over here in the user type, I'll do admin, admin, and now this cookie has been changed to admin. And now let me reload this, and you can see over here your admin dashboard, and now I am the admin. So this thing is like quite unrealistic and won't happen actually, but this is just a small something. Alright, so second, let's go here, remote code execution. We'll do remote code execution via insecure deserialization, the practical which you were I here for. Alright, so let's start the step-by-step process. Alright, so let me just change the cookie back to user again. It's like not changing the cookie at all. Alright, it's the same. Let me load this. Alright, so now I am again the user. So now when I click on feedback, I'll get this page. Okay, so in this feedback form, I'll go and I'll click on inspect element and again check the cookies. And over here, this one, in this cookie, I will do some changes. And you can see this cookie is again, I can just copy this and I can paste it here, is again base 64. So now here I'll do some changes and I'll put my own cookie value. Okay, so firstly, they have told us to get that reverse shell of ours so that we can do that remote code execution. This is the code, and they have provided us with the code. Alright, so just imagine that I have this code for now. This is a code which is just base 64 encoding, and this is the command which we have to do. So in my terminal, I am going to do make a file rc.py. Alright, and I'm going to paste this code. Then over here, when this asks for the IP, I have to put my own IP because this is just a generalized, you can say as a payload, for it to connect back to my own PC. So I'll take my ID and I'll copy this and I'll paste it here. Alright, now I'll save this, control O, enter, control X. Okay, so I can even cat this file. So this is the code. Now I'll run this file. So by actually adding this, my IP, I actually changed this already available code as per my requirements so as to connect to my computer. Let me run this and I got this value. So the only thing now I'm going to do is over here, I'm going to change the cookie. So when I just showed you the previous time, when I showed that rather than doing user, if I'll do it as admin, I'll become admin, because the site is picking up data from my site, from my cookie. It's like too much dependent on the cookie to get values, like even a really sensitive value like this, it is asking. So over here too, I'll just go and I'll change this and I'll paste that custom cookie which I just made. Alright, so I'll set this up, I'll close this, and again I'll reload it. So you can check that my cookie is here, GASV, this is the cookie. And since we are doing a netcat listener at 4444, let's start netcat. So netcat.lvnp 4444, and now let's reload. So when I reload, there is nothing you can see over here, but we got a bash over here. So we did a remote code execution where we run this command on that place, and all of this ran, and we got our bin as such, like we got our bin. So only thing now left to do is to actually, we can do anything right now. So let's do ls, so I got this, and let's do ls dash la, and I see there is this directory is there. This is another directory. Okay, so as for like for finishing touches, what is the flag.txt? So we'll do find all dash name flag.txt to greater than slash def slash null, and I got the answer. This is the place, and I'll just cat it, and I got my flag. So in this you can see that we used cookies, where we changed cookies to get this answer, and we were actually able to get a bash. And if I'll do who am I, you can see that I am now as a proper logged in user. So I can even maybe let's I can actually do kind of anything right now. If I am able to do pseudo privilege escalation or something, then yeah, at least you are inside this server. So I've already exploited it. So you can, I have shown you the practical, and I hope you like this video, and please like and subscribe, and see you next time.